Children, good morning. I am your English teacher, teaching of English. In the previous class, we already completed 9th paragraph of the lesson, The Boy Who Sold Wisdom. Now I will read the 10th paragraph. Now Gupta was not pleased. He saw that his son would have to feign madness always, or else the king would find out he had been tricked. He would certainly chop off his son's head if he found out. So back they went to Nagendra for more wisdom. For another 500 rupees, Nagendra advised them, "Go back to the king when he is in a good mood and tell him the whole story. He will find it amusing and will forgive you. But make sure he is in a mood of laughter." And so Babu followed the advice, found the king in a merry mood, and told him the story. The king laughed a lot and forgave him. Explain the 10th paragraph. Babu's father approached Nagendra for the second time. This was because Babu, who had escaped punishment by acting insane, had now to pretend to be insane always. For if the king learnt that he had been tricked, the punishment would be worse. Nagendra now advised Babu and his father to reveal the truth to the king when the king was in a good mood. This advice was given for a fee of another 500 rupees. Nagendra assured them that the king would find the whole incident amusing and would forgive them. As predicted by Nagendra, the king, who was in a happy mood, not only had a hearty laugh when he heard them, but also forgave them. Next paragraph, 11th and 12th para. Then the king, who was intrigued by what he had heard of Nagendra in the market, sent for him and asked if he had any more wisdom to sell. The boy said, "Of course, I have plenty to sell, especially to a king, but my fee would be 100,000 rupees. The king paid him the 100,000, and the boy gave him a piece of paper on which he had written, "Think deeply before you do anything." The king was so delighted with the advice that he made it his motto. He had it embroidered on his pillows and engraved on his cups and plates, so that he would not forget it. Explain the 11th and 12th paragraph. The king, who by now had heard about Nagendra, invited him to the palace. He wanted to find out if Nagendra had any more advice to sell. Nagendra explained that he had plenty to sell, especially for a king. He also stated that the fees would be 100,000 rupees. The king paid the requested sum and received the wisdom. It was to think deeply before doing anything. The king was so impressed with the advice that he got it engraved on his cups, plates, and even got them embroidered on his pillows. Next, 13th and 14th paragraph. Some months later, the king fell ill. The minister had one of the queens had been conspiring to get rid of him. So they bribed the doctor and persuaded him to poison the king's medicine. When the medicine was brought to the king and he lifted the golden cup to his lips, he read the words engraved on it, "Think deeply before you doing anything." Without suspecting anything, he thought about the words, lowered the cup, and looked at the medicine in it. The doctor, who was watching all this, felt nervous. His guilty conscience made him believe that the king had guessed that his medicine had been poisoned. While the king was thinking, the doctor threw him at his feet and confessed to everything and prayed to be forgiven. But the king ordered that the doctor must be arrested. Then
He sent for the minister and the queen and insisted that they drink the poison in his cup. They too fell at his feet and begged for mercy. He ordered them to be hanged and he banished the doctor from his kingdom. He made Nagendra his minister and honored him with wealth.
Explain the 13th and 14th paragraph. It so happened that many months later the king fell sick. The minister and one of his queens who wanted to get rid of him bribed the doctor to poison the king's medicine. When the king was about to consume the medicine from the golden cup, he read the words engraved on it. The king, who was unaware of the poison in his cup, lowered the cup, looked into the cup, pondering over the words engraved on it. The guilty doctor, who was watching the king, assumed that the king had guessed that the medicine was poisoned. He fell at the king's feet, confessed everything and pleaded for mercy. The king sent for the queen and the minister. He asked them to drink the poison. They too fell at the feet of the king and asked for mercy. The king ordered them to be hanged and banished the doctor from his kingdom. Nagendra was made the minister and honored with wealth.